Hi, welcome back to the Music Reviewer. This time, we're going to review Gibson Les Paul Jr., my own personal Gibson Les Paul Jr. I'm happy about that. Gibson Les Paul Jr. is one of my favorite guitars, and I'm happy to finally, after 10 years of wanting one and playing them in shops and stuff like that, I finally got enough money to pay for one. So, and I didn't just buy a specific one. I played them, I tried them out, and found one that I absolutely fell in love with, and I paid for that one. And that one so happens to be a Billie Joe Armstrong signature. And it is absolutely an immaculate guitar, to me anyway. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mess with my sleeves. And I'll pull it out in a second. And it's, I have to warn you, when I grab it, it's going to make a fair bit of noise, as in, because it's a P90 and the amp is right there. Like, here's the guitar, amp is just here, out of frame, and there's a PA system on the other side, so the frequencies are hitting each other, and it's basically the pickup is absolutely being shredded by it. So as I'll turn it up for a second here. You hear that? But it's worth it, trust me. When it gets to it, it's absolutely worth it. So let me tell you a little about the Les Paul Jr. As anyone who's watched my videos before, you've noticed that I have reviewed a vintage brand Les Paul Jr. The brand is vintage. They're very good guitars. I'd recommend them heavily. Great quality control. And it was very, very good. As I stated in the video, the only thing I didn't like about it myself is the neck. The neck was a baseball bat. And as anyone else knows, I pay for all the stuff I review. I've bought them. And as I said in that video, at the time of that video being recorded, I had sold it. It was gone the next day. And so I'm going to quickly go in about this. It is a full fat Gibson right on top. It is a Billie Joe Armstrong signature. His signature is just up there. And I love Green Day. I love Les Paul Juniors, and I actually picked up this guitar before I even knew it was a Billie Joe Armstrong signature. It was just more of a, I saw it in a shop. The shop I seen it in was some of the guitars. I heavily recommend them. They're in Dublin, and just go in, give them a shout. They have a lot of very good guitars on the walls. It's amazing to see what's next to the doorway. But anyway, about this guitar, has one volume and one tone, one pickup. Everyone says you're a bit limited, but you're only limited by what you can do as a player. As in, it doesn't have a neck, but you can emulate a neck pickup, which I demonstrated before in a previous video. Just roll down your tone. Roll down your tone to a point where it sounds creamy. And then that's your neck. Another thing you can do is, other thing that I do a lot of the time is, my volume is at 6 and my tone is at 7. And I try not to use this boost pedal here on the pedal unless I really need to. So acoustically, it's lovely. It's absolutely lovely sounding acoustically. And basically, I'm just going to give you a little bit backstory on this guitar, where it came out, where it came from. You know, it's a Billie Joe Armstrong signature, but it was actually designed on Billie Joe Armstrong's studio and gigging guitar, Floyd. It's his original 59, I believe, 54, something like that. Gibson Les Paul Jr. And it's been done to the spec of it. Exact spec bar the neck. The neck was done by a 60s. So it's a little bit thinner, a little bit easier to get your hand around. I've done a little bit of a modification to it myself, as in I've swapped out the soap bar for a lightning bar. That way I have the intonation. So I can play. So I can play in two on both sides of the neck. Handy as hell. So, I'm going to start playing because I want to. But before I start playing, that camera has got to go down there. Okay, so here she is in all her glory. This one I have named, it's Perry. I've named it Perry because I like the name Perry. And I bought it in the year 2017. This guitar was made in 2011. And the reason I named it Perry is because in 2017, Billie Joe Armstrong starred in a movie called Ordinary World, and his character that he played in it was named Perry. So, Perry. So I'm going to shut up and get to the guitar. That's the noise I was on about. Here, see? Anyway, I'm gonna start off with. There's a lot of variety in this guitar, no matter what anyone tells you. This is 3 on the volume. With the tone fully up as well. Here, let me knock the tone off. See how different that is? Right here. That's still with distortion, by the way. So I'm going to turn distortion off. And I'll just let you go. I'd bummed a note. Like the volume's fully up now, so turn on some dirt. Well, I'm going to turn the dirt back on. And I'm going to turn off the tone completely. It's a really bluesy sound. Thank you. kept the tune. Rhythm tone is volume on about 6 or 5, and the tone full up if you want. But like, like, that was full on 10. So I'm gonna turn it down to 6. That sounds off. Gibsons, they're annoying to stay in through. Make it perfectly clear that I'm hitting nothing down here when I'm doing this. It's genuinely all the sounds I'm getting is genuinely for me doing this, for this with the guitar. Like, something. thing is though about Les Paul Juniors and single coil, not single coil, single pickup guitars. It's more of they're a lot of time using punk music and stuff like that, to where you got like the Ramones with that. And of course, Green Day. So, I've been the music reviewer. Thank you for watching. If you liked what you've seen, please subscribe. And if you want to be notified by me uploading content, make sure to hit that bell beside the subscribe. But yeah, I can never say this right. By the subscribe button. And I've been the music reviewer, as I believe I've said. And this has been my Les Paul Jr. And thank you for watching.